Hello and welcome back to the channel. Previously, we've been analyzing a lot of the modern film's aspects, but this time, we'll be looking at the early film styles of Hollywood and try to discover the convention in film noir. According to Britannica, film noir is a style of filmmaking characterized by such elements as cynical heroes, stark lighting effects, frequent use of flashbacks, intricate plots, and underlying existentialist philosophy. The genre was prevalent mostly in American crime dramas of the post-World War II era. The movie chosen today was The Stranger, directed by Orson Welles back in 1946. According to Steve-O, The Stranger was Orson Welles' third film directed, but the previous two were box office failure. And this is his first attempt at a film noir, and also his first box office success. As a film noir, The Stranger sure have a number of conventions following the preference of the viewers back then, which is why it had made Orson Welles' third attempt at a successful one, as following the major market preference was an important factor in the film industry. At start off, we could see the overall theme of the film was about evil, love, betrayal, and revenge, as expected from a typical film noir. However, these elements were joined well to present quite an interesting story to the viewer in the film. As the main villain in the story, Franz Kindler serves as the core evil in the film, having the story resolved around him, while his wife Mary has brought out the element of love, willing to support her husband although he was not the person she thought he was. But eventually, Franz Kindler betrayed her love and tried to kill her as she started to doubt her trust. Then in the end, Mary went for her revenge to kill Kindler. Character-wise, we could see the typical setup starring Mr. Wilson as a detective role, trying to hunt down Franz Kindler through different ways. Mary, on the other hand, served both as the good woman and also a femme fatale, being all good towards Charles Rankin, but turns towards him and tries to kill him with a gun near the end of the film. We could also see most people in the film smokes no matter the gender, as it was a signature of power back then, but women tend to smoke cigarettes as its shape and vibe suits a female's more, being lighter and elegant, while a cigar typically suits men with heavy coat and hat being calmer and steadier. As the film is in black and white, we could see a lot of high contrast lighting to emphasize the shadowing of the characters to achieve different effects, mainly to make the scene more dramatic. This also helps to create a sense of mystery in the film, as the story is about a detective trying to hunt down a criminal. The emphasis of shadowing is also brought out not only in the scene, but also in the dialogue, when Mary was talking about her dreams of the little man. The use of low and high angles can both be seen in the film, as well as the constant use of close-up shots to the character whenever they were talking. Numbers of reflection mechanisms were also used in the film, mainly at the start of the story and also in the mirror of the pub, behind the reception desk of Mr. Porter, where he always plays checker with. As a conclusion, we could see a clear view of the use of several conventions in the making of a film noir, but it wasn't really a bad thing. Having a convention means to know about what the audiences want at the moment, and will surely benefit in filmmaking until nowadays. Thank you and see you next time.